Welcome back to another amazing episode of Trailer Trashing, the podcast where we watch and make fun of movie trailers. I am your host, Joey Rinaldi, and joining me as they do every week is our chief editor producer, Charlie Weinschenk. And also joining us is Mr. Sleepy Sleepyhead, Derek Blythe. Good morning, Derek.
Hey, all you dukes and duchesses out in Radio Land.
Yeah, baby.
Are you gonna start saying that every episode now? Because I kind of love just, it.
I heard I was listening to like 1970s radio, and I heard a guy say that, and it changed my life.
Derek, ever since you showed me that cool app, wait, let me. I forget the name of it. It's called Radio Garden.
Radio Garden, right?
Yeah. So it's this app where like you can get radio stations all over the world, and I've been like fucking losing my mind. I found this like Japanese like metal station. And it's the totally different, it's like music that I would never listen to otherwise. And right. It's like changing my emotions, I feel like.
I love this app. We are not sponsored by this app, but I will sing its praises.
Yet.
Yeah, they should sponsor us. Give us your money
Especially at the beginning of coronavirus, I was just kind of desperately going around. And it was, I don't know if, it was weirdly comforting, but also terrifying that every country was going through it at the same time.
Yeah. Oh,
would you hear it on their radio stations?
Yeah, because I'd go to the English-speaking countries and it'd be like South Africa, Australia, and Australia would be like, oh, yeah, we got a lot of cases. You got to stay indoors. And I'd be like, okay. I'd be like really terrified in an apocalyptic way, but also comforted at the same time.
Globalism.
Because there was like that tiny little period where it was kind of just in New York. For at least America.
I totally relate with that. During the corona times, I stopped like watching like streaming stuff like Hulu and Netflix. I got really into like cable and FM radio because I feel like when I was watching Netflix and Hulu, I was like isolated from knowing what's happening in the world. But when you watch like FM, listen to FM radio or watch cable, you get updates. Like people will talk about stuff and I was like, oh, I'm not the only one who thinks the world's ending.
Right.
And so
I
totally understand that notion of listening to
it scratches
Australian
my
radio.
The nerdiest itch I have, which is for shortwave radio, which I've talked to you about before. But I've got the expensive looping cables and stuff.
A few months ago, it was like 4 a.m. and you were just showing me the craziest radio stations where it was like Russian little girls counting numbers nonstop, like 1, 2, 3.
But it's I love those. They're crazy real life mysteries, you know?
Oh, yeah.
I love that.
And if you're listening to this, you probably have no idea what we're talking about. So I'll just introduce today's theme. Today's theme is dancing movies. That's right. You love dancing. We love dancing. And we're going to watch movie trailers where we dance. Derek's a great dancer. Charlie, I feel like
you
have a dance move in you.
If you're lucky.
Have you got the itch in your bones?
My bones are so itchy. It's a rare condition.
That's why we all dance.
I'm really excited to embrace dancing movies because as a kid, I loved like movies like Step Up, Bring It On. And I was like afraid to like tell my friends about it because I was like, guys aren't supposed to like dancing movies. But it's 2020 now, and I don't need to live in this shell. I can say dancing movies are fun. I'm a big ABBA fan. When I'm alone, I drink wine, listen to ABBA, and dance my heart out.
I mean, ABBA is fantastic, whether you like dancing movies or not.
Yet they're undeniably good. The best pop group of all time.
That and also, it's like I know we're doing dancing movies as the theme, and like I feel like Step Up and all that stuff, or Stomp the Yard is like what you think of, but and so we have like one of those kind of movies, right? But there we had to cover a little bit of like a wider spread of this kind of stuff because not all dancing movies are just like those are movies where it's like a musical, but instead of breaking into song randomly,
they bring in a dance.
Yeah.
We finish each other's sentences. I love it.
Yeah, but so we've also got the ones where it's I don't know. I guess I don't know. We have Dirty Dancing. That's not like that at all, really, right? That's more like a regular narrative movie.
Yeah, it's a regular dancing where like I'm not supposed to dance, but the boys are hot, so I'll dance.
You're not supposed to dance in any of these movies.
Yeah,
if you're supposed to dance in the dancing movie, then you don't have a dancing movie.
Well, except for my favorite dance movie of all time that we're not watching. I want to apologize to Mr. Jonathan Travolta. We're not doing Saturday Night Fever, but I feel like that was a pro dancing movie.
I don't think his family wanted him to dance.
Yeah, but his parents
they just wanted him to eat his dinner.
But his parents were like in two or three scenes total.
Right.
I don't think I've seen that one.
Oh, well, it's a good one.
There's some authority figure that doesn't want you to dance in every single one.
I guess, yeah, that's true. What's up with that?
They got old and they lost the itch in their bones.
Yeah, I think it's also like they all are made by people like Joey who felt like it wasn't okay or acceptable for them to dance.
Right.
I just want to dance,
you have
baby.
To, you know, you have to make a movie that I started a sentence and then I lost it.
Well, no, but Charlie, you are right.
Bees buzzing around in my skull. Oh.
But Charlie, you are right. The writer of Dirty Dancing wrote it about her life because she actually like wasn't allowed to dance dirty, and then she was like, "I'm gonna dirty dance anyways." And like she was actually called baby at the dance place that she would go dancing with the hot guys. So like, you're totally right. She didn't feel like she could dance. I don't feel like I could dance, and it's all connected.
It's because what is more of a freedom of expression than dancing the night away? Because you just get out there and you do whatever you feel and you're free. You're free as can be. And then all of a sudden you have to get an abortion. But abortions are illegal.
Whoa.
And
whoa. Spoiler. And also we always have to bring up abortion at least like once a month. We bring up abortion on this podcast.
Well, this is a completely relevant plot point because that's what the movie's about.
When I watched Dirty Dancing for the first time, I was so confused. I was like, they're going to do... Is this happening? They're going for it. Like, I did not see that coming. It was from left field. But I'm glad they went for it.
Yeah, in a world where everyone's doing the Lindy Hop and all the dances are really coordinated and 5 feet apart from your partner, you really just want to get down and just grind on your moist dance partner. You just got to really ride up on them.
Dancing leads to sex. I have always said that.
That's why it's banned, because there's nothing sexier than a male versus female dance party. Well, is that? I don't know how dancing works.
I don't know how dancing works. No one would ever dance with me. That's why I only dance by myself to ABBA. But before we spoil Dirty Dancing anymore, I think it's time we fucking watch that trailer.
Roll it.
Roll it.
The heat is in the music. The music sets you dancing. The dancing sets her free. Best Drawn Pictures presents Dirty Dancing. She thought it would be just another summer vacation.
Who's that?
Oh, them. They're the dance people.
But it turns out to be the time of her life.
Watch me now!
I can't even do the merengue.
He teaches her what she can do.
I'm not sure who you are, but I don't want you to have anything to do with those people again.
Baby, I don't see you running up to Daddy telling him I'm your guy.
Well, with my father, it's complicated. I will tell him.
I don't believe you, baby.
She shows him all he can be.
You gotta stop it now.
I know what I'm doing, Penny.
I'm scared of everything. Most of all, I'm scared of walking out of this room and never feeling the rest of my whole life the way I feel when I'm with you.
What they learn from each other feels too good to be wrong. Dirty Dancing, starring Patrick Swayze, Jennifer Grey, and Cynthia Rhodes. Get ready for the time of your life.
Jesus Christ. I saw that movie. I liked it. But if I watched that trailer, I don't think I would have ever watched that movie. Jesus.
Yeah. I watched that movie when I was really young.
More questions than answers.
Yeah.
I really just like the font.
The font, yeah. Charlie and I,
good font,
we're snobs. Charlie and I are snobs for typography. Is that how you say it? And that was some good typography, fontological.
Great 80s typeface.
Yeah.
I believe it's called Outrun Future.
Woo! Shout out to all the nerds at the New School in New York City for loving typography.
Let's do a quick 10-minute shout out to that. Let's silence, no talking, boys. Starting now.
We have to name everyone in
the New School
design department at the New School in Manhattan. I'd like to thank Professor.
Quick shout out to Courier New, Futura, Bold, and Italic.
Quick shout out to Wolfpack for having not one but two custom fonts that are available.
They're
Did you know that?
Good.
Do they really?
No, I didn't know that.
Dude, I love Wolfpack. I was so shocked that Wolfpack was a nerdy white guy, because that dude sounds
not
like
only white but Jewish.
Whoa! Now I'm not allowed to listen to him. Just kidding. I'm pro Jews.
I'm just kidding.
I'm doing a Seinfeld impression. I like the Jews.
All right, so enough about fonts.
I hate that trailer. That trailer sucks. Jennifer Grey's awkward in that movie, but this trailer only got the most awkward parts of her. And
it's true. I felt like it was almost like, have you ever noticed how in Seinfeld, bringing it back, that he always is about to laugh? That's what she looked like, too.
She always looked like she's about to laugh, and she's annoying. I actually don't like Jennifer Grey. She really doesn't do it for me. And she does it for me in this movie, but the trailer makes it seem as if she wouldn't do it for me in this movie. Does that make sense?
I don't feel as strongly about this trailer as you do. I mean, I get what you're saying. She was kind of awkward, but it's like, isn't that kind of like...
kind of her character. So
she's awkward. She's trying to learn how to dance. What's more awkward than that?
But in the movie...
This guy's
like
touching her up and stuff in these sexy dances, and she's like, I don't know, my dad. I don't know if he's going to like this.
But in the movie, Baby was like awkwardly likable. In the trailer, she was awkwardly hateable, which is funny because when they...
I don't know about hateable.
When they screened this movie, the first screening of this movie, everyone hated it so much that the production company or the producers, they thought they were going to have to go straight to VCR.
Really?
Yeah.
But well, this is boy, such a classic.
Boy, I know. They were wrong as fuck. It's a it made tons of money.
Yeah. It's the font, though. It's the font.
It's the font.
It's not any of the acting or the screenplay or the plot.
Derek, how did you feel about this god-awful trailer?
As the only person here who has not seen this movie...
You haven't seen it?
No.
You would love it, Derek. It's
I've been
so
busy.
Good.
Yeah, this is a you movie, man.
It's really good.
I could watch it. Anyway, to judge the trailer, all I could think about was, why does she need to learn to dance?
Yeah, true.
I don't know if
it
explained it. It just... Cut
they
to
did not
the
explain
montage.
It in the trailer.
They're dancing on a log. They're dancing on a bridge. They're dancing on a river.
It's kind
of
like
Charlie,
Karate
Kid. Can you explain what the trailer looked like for the people at home?
Yeah, it really didn't explain anything. It kind of just jumped right into, like, we're teaching this girl to dance.
She doesn't know how to dance. Like, stressed out. Like, I need to learn. And I'm like, why?
And then she's like,
I need to learn by Saturday.
Like, I need to learn, but also like, hey, I don't know. My dad's like not really into this whole thing and he's going to get mad. And he's like, I don't think you got it in you. You can't, you're just going to walk away. And she's like, I'm not going to walk away, but my
only like clean dancing, clean dancing.
So I can, you want me to spoil it? I can spoil it if you want.
Wait, I want a little bit too, because I have a good analogy. This is kind of like the Karate Kid of dancing. She goes on vacation and she stumbles upon, she's this rich girl. If you don't mind, Joey, I'm going to just do it. You can do it too.
Spoil it away, baby.
Do it at the same time, boys.
But don't put, don't put baby in the corner.
Okay,
nobody,
and the funny part is I seen this movie, but I really thought that baby was the other girl. Because I don't remember it.
Baby's the main character. That's the whole point of the fucking movie.
I thought
movie.
Baby was the
you
other
You know what?
Girl.
I don't think you're allowed to do this
no,
anymore.
No,
you
I
just,
have,
you
I just
don't
lied.
Know the
no.
character's names.
Charlie, you just, I'm sorry.
I
was going to give you
the
chance.
Names.
I was going to give you the chance, but you just blew it.
No,
Derek,
let me prove to you I know it. Let me
okay,
prove to
I'll
you
give
I...
you a second chance. But if you say one more stupid thing, I swear to God, I'm going to cut you off.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Okay, so basically she's this, like, you know, upper-class rich girl who's on vacation with her dad or something. And
family, mom, dad, and sister. You're so bad at this.
So she is on vacation, and she's kind of going off on her own in this resort, and she finds that all the workers in the resort have these secret dance parties in, like, this, like, I don't know, like, broom closet.
Like the basement.
Oh, it's like a Disney cruise.
Yeah, and so they're all dancing, and she's so upper class that she's never seen this, like, you know, poor people.
I thought you were going to tell a short version. This is so long already.
Well, I'm almost done, and then she sees that. She sees them, like, grinding up on each other, and she's like, whoa, this isn't what they have at the cotillion.
She gets all horned up.
You're not even at the plot yet.
Yo, this is the plot, and then she wants to be part of it, and she learns, and
no,
she gets...
No, that's not it at all, dude.
The end, the
what
end.
What happens is she meets a hot... No, you fucked it up. What happens is she meets a hot guy that dances sexy, and she wants to, like, be with him, but the thing is, he's, like, the dancer for, like, the shows at nighttime. Like, they have, like, big shows every night for the rich people, and mm-hmm. And they have a big show on Saturday, and the girl that he was going to dance with gets pregnant, and she doesn't want to dance with her pregnant body because then she gets, like, an abortion and she can't dance
illegally
anymore.
Because they're not allowed. They're
so she,
like,
so she,
bad
so
kind.
She can't dance anymore. And Patrick Swayze's like, I'm sexy and I need a dance partner. And she's like, even though I don't know how to dance, you shouldn't pick somebody that already knows how to dance. You should pick me because I want to fuck you. And he goes, that's a good point. Let's fuck.
It's like Karate Kid.
That's
too,
why she has to learn how to dance. I'm still confused.
Because he needs a dance partner for Saturday's big show.
Why does she have to do it?
Because
she wants to fuck him.
It's a little bit of a Lady and the Tramp thing. She's like you know, they.
I'm giving this trailer. I'm giving this trailer a hard nose 3.
I give it a 5.
Derek.
5 also.
And give me your tomato scores, baby.
It was okay.
I mean, like,
it's a classic
movie,
classic.
Like we were pointing out, the plot is that of, like, I don't know, like a B movie. You know what I mean?
Like Seinfeld B movie?
I think I've seen at least 5 Bollywood movies with the same plot.
Yeah, it's like you have to dance and fall in love.
So what's your tomato score, people?
Who goes first?
80.
Looks like Derek goes first.
Derek goes first.
86.
Charlie?
No. Okay. Right.
No, you said 86. I'm not going to let you do this back and forth silly word.
I'm not arguing with you.
I'm sorry.
I'm
sorry,
I'm
Derek.
Torn.
You didn't deserve that. That was fucked up.
But, like, tell me if I'm wrong here. Like, I'm a little torn because
give
it's
it a,
like,
no. Go with your gut. We've talked about this. I want to help you.
Is a classic movie.
But no,
but
I want your gut.
The plot is kind of weak and stupid.
Give me the gut, baby. I love your gut.
This is like a sexy movie for, like, middle-aged women who need the love and the sexy.
No, I think it's sexy for all women. I think all women get wet watching this.
72. Ah, it's going to be higher than that.
No, Charlie wins. It was 68. You were spot on. I told you.
Yeah.
If you go with your gut, you can beat this Derek guy. I don't even know this Derek guy, but
I just
me.
Had to close my eyes and let whatever number come out.
So before we go to Roger Ebert, I think it's time for Joey's Fun Facts of the Day. It's Joey's time to tell fun facts. We love it. Derek loves it. Charlie loves it. Let me tell some fun facts. I think the listeners kind of like it. So Patrick Swayze and Jennifer Grey hate each other. They didn't want to work together. They worked on Red Dawn together, and they absolutely, like, hated each other and, like, didn't even talk to each other.
Oh, so they already knew each other?
Yeah. So they casted Patrick Swayze, and then they wanted Jennifer Grey. And Jennifer Grey was like, fuck you. I'm not going to do this. I hate Patrick Swayze. But Patrick Swayze realized that Jennifer Grey was perfect for this role, and he called her up and was like, hey, sister, I hate you. But let's do what's best for our careers. Let's do this.
That's a better imagine. That's better than the movie plot.
Yeah, that is a
better
plot.
I know. So the most famous line of the movie, nobody puts baby in the corner, almost didn't happen because Patrick Swayze was like, fuck that line. It makes no sense. But the director was like, you need to say it. And I think I speak for all the boys and gals that were glad that Patrick Swayze said it.
I could just imagine though, like that Patrick Swayze and Jennifer Grey just like show up on the set and then they just like there's a close up of their eyes like in a kung fu movie and they're just like you, and then they start dirty dancing on each
other.
Well,
it's funny that you say that, Charlie, because they're supposed to like hate each other in this movie when like so they hate each other throughout this whole movie, by the way, until they fall in love. And it's really funny because there's a scenes when like they're mad at each other that wasn't scripted because they were actually mad at each other. And the director was like, keep rolling, boys, keep rolling. And one of those scenes is there's a famous scene in this movie where Jennifer Grey is like laughing, making fun of Patrick Swayze. And Patrick Swayze is like really self-conscious, like, stop laughing at me. That actually wasn't scripted. That was actually off screen that they just got luckily by chance of film magic.
Just film magic and just lucky that they fucking hated each other.
God, I'm going to rapid fire because all these fun facts are gold. Jennifer Grey did not know how to dance before the movie, so she literally had to learn how to dance scene by scene as Baby learned. Like, so as Baby is learning how to dance in the movie, Jennifer Grey is also learning how to dance. Wow, isn't that kind of spectacular?
I mean, it's not even, this is like a documentary at this point.
All right, I'm almost done. This is the most fun facts I've ever done for one movie. They're just so good. This movie has, wait for it, the greatest fun facts of all time. one more thing. You know that big thing that's like the famous scene of the movie where like Patrick Swayze has Jennifer Grey on his hand and she's like in the air. It's like the poster of the movie.
Mm-hmm.
I swear to God, they only did that one time, ever. And they nailed it.
That's good.
Cause she was.
Love to hear it.
She was so. You guys aren't impressed by that fun fact.
It's fine. It's an alright fact. They did a thing in one take.
It's amazing because she was afraid to do it. Jennifer was like, "I'm afraid of doing that. I never want to do it."
That's probably why they only did it one time.
I know, but that they nailed it. That's such a hard dance move to nail.
These are the craziest, swaziest facts.
All right, you guys are. There's somebody listening to this that's like, Joey, I'm here with you. I feel you. These are crazy. And to you listening, I love you. And you're a good
the
person.
The hardcore Joey trailer heads or whatever we call you.
All right. You want to do casting what ifs and then we'll go to Roger Ebert.
Yeah, but I already clicked on the Roger Ebert, and I'm like holding in my like whoa moment because you gave it a 1 star. Whoa, he gave it a 1 star.
Let me do the casting what ifs. The fans are gonna love this.
But isn't that crazy? Whoa, 1 star. That's bad. That's bad.
Okay, they almost casted Sarah Jessica Parker and Sharon Stone for Baby.
They almost casted two people. I'm glad they decided to go with this.
Wait, Derek. How bad would their Dirty Dancing be if they casted Billy Zane or Val Kilmer to play Patrick Swayze?
No, Val Kilmer would have been fine.
No!
Val Kilmer is kind of like Patrick Swayze.
No!
They're both guys with the hairdo from
Patrick
the
Swayze's a one of a kind Jack motherfucker.
You don't think Val Kilmer is buff?
All right, I'm done with my fun facts.
In 87, he's about to be Batman, but I don't know what that says about his dancing.
Val Kilmer?
He's in shape.
Yeah. Val Kilmer was already Batman. He's doing it again?
No, at this time.
Oh, in 1987.
The time of this movie.
You know, I knew he wasn't 87 right now. I thought you were saying that now he's 87, and as an 87-year-old, it's very impressive because he's about to be a Batman in a Batman movie.
Batman is 87 years old, and Robin is... left to go to like, you know, have like a finance job and like leave Batman.
That's
behind.
Like SpongeBob. That's like
Barnacle. Oh yeah.
Roger Ebert gave it 1 star. Whoa. Come on, guys.
Bad.
That's how now you know how I feel when you guys weren't impressed by fun fact list.
He did this in 1987. Wow. Let's do this last paragraph.
Oh, I'm excited.
This movie could have been about the subject it pussyfoots around so coyly.
Pussyfoots?
Yeah, you never heard that before?
No, but I love that saying.
Pussyfoot is like tiptoe. It could have found a big scene a little more original than the heroine stepping in for the injured star. I guess that's what we were saying, too. It could have made the obnoxious owner's son less of a one-dimensional SOB. But the movie plays like one long, sad compromise. It places packaging ahead of ambition. Where did I get that idea? I don't know. Maybe from the title. He didn't like the font.
So I love Ebert. And even though I disagree with Ebert cold-heartedly, because I think this movie deserves at least a 2-star.
Cold-heartedly.
He swung me a little bit because once like Ebert starts talking his fun words, I'm like, he may have a point. Ebert is just a great reviewer.
Yeah, I mean, he said everything that we were saying. I mean, there's nothing to argue. He said that the plot was weak. And we were talking about it because we were trying to figure out what the plot was. But speaking of 1987, Derek, you have something that comes out 1 year later in 1988. That's
1988.
Right.
Oh, yes. Can you please tell the boys and gems and girls and guys and dolls about it?
Sure. The latest installment of Bill and Teresa LeBeau premieres tomorrow. Well, at the time of this, it'll already be out by the time you're hearing this.
But you can still watch it.
It'll be up on most all platforms, YouTube, like Instagram, Facebook, VHS as well.
And who is Bill LeBeau and the other person?
They are from an alternate reality where they were the biggest superstars of their time. And they did a lot of horrible things and committed a lot of crimes. And this special happens to be the Halloween special, sort of their version of Thriller. It takes place in Halloween 1988. Because of the major historical event this year in 2020, we cannot do a live show like we usually do most holidays. But so for that reason, we're putting up sort of a found footage kind of deal that it plays out a lot like our show would, but it's like a VHS tape they found years later of the supposed cursed album and show that never was.
So wow. For the boys and girls out there, Derek Blythe and his friend Kat Dookie are amazing musical duo.
That's not her name.
That's her Instagram name.
Yeah.
What well, is her real
They're a musical duo, and they have this hilarious show, and it's now going to have a special, and you guys all got to check it out. And it's going to be on YouTube, you said?
It'll be there, too.
Yeah, check
Where
it out.
Where is it premiering? Where is it premiering?
On all the platforms.
Whoa, that's crazy.
So look up Soupy Garbage. Look up Soupy Garbage Juice on Instagram for more info. And now
Instagram LeBeau.video.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's better. That's better. Now let's move on to our second movie trailer, which is You Got Served.
Tell me, what is this?
Dance movie.
Dance movie. This is the one that we're doing that's like Stomp the Yard, right?
Well, let's watch and figure it out.
It's time to see which one of these crews y'all like the best. All right, let's do this.
You don't know now, but you go find out.
Party people, your dreams have now been fulfilled. Get out your seats and let's get ill. We're not just wrong, it's Project Blow.
Seems to me like the money in the hat goes to David and Ed.
They were the best of friends.
I know you better than anybody. I know when you're tripping. What's up?
I'm not like you, B. I can't just sit around and dream.
Their crew was unstoppable.
We just got a $5,000 challenge from some rich kid out of Orange County.
Let's do this again sometime.
Get out of my face. What's the matter with you? No fight!
You're just mad. Because tonight, you suckers got served.
Tell me last night didn't happen.
How the hell we lose 5 G's in 10 minutes, man?
So, Rick, the big bounce, that's what's up.
$50,000.
Yes, man, just enough money to change our life.
Now.
Hey.
What you doing with Leah?
Calm down.
So, my mama, you ain't getting with my sister.
He's playing you, Leah. Now stay away from him.
Don't be talking to her like that.
If they want their shot.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm Lila at the big bounce. We got the hottest crews competing for $50,000.
They'll have to come together.
You're not gonna win this without David, and you know it.
David ain't getting down with my crew no matter what.
Wish you the best of luck, all right, bro?
We need David, and we need to do it as a team.
Look, we don't have David.
This is crew against crew, just like we do it on the streets. Well, you're funny now, but you won't be when we get on the floor.
It's showtime!
What you want us to get?
You know how I like it, baby. Straight hood.
Derek, thank you so much for picking this movie.
This is your
Derek.
Choice, Derek. Wow, gymnastics and dancing have never been so masculine. You know what I mean?
Derek, thanks for picking this movie. This was fucking amazing. One of the best trailers I've ever seen.
Surprise was, Steve Harvey.
There was Steve Harvey. There was great dancing. There was some TNA. And there was some good old-fashioned West Side Story thing going on with, like, guys and guys fighting each other with the power of dance.
Guys fighting. It was, yeah, it was a dance battle movie.
Steve Harvey and Lil' Kim are in this. Like, those are two legends.
Yeah. I was really just surprised to see Steve Harvey.
He was the first thing you saw in the trailer.
Yeah. He's the big name.
I got to collect myself. That was a lot. That was a lot.
Yeah. Tell everybody what this was, what was going on in this show. I want to hear it from you.
You want my perspective? No.
I want to hear.
Okay. So basically, this group of cool dudes have this like really hip like breakdancing dance crew. And the thing is, they go to these competitions where like they have to put a lot of money on the line, like 5 G's, yo. And the thing is, they thought they were gonna like win it. But then all of a sudden, these trust fund white boys come over and they kick their asses. Like, they totally fucking breakdance better than anyone's ever breakdanced before. And then the boys, our favorite people, have to like recollect themselves and be like, we gotta get better at this shit. And they're gonna go for like a 50G competition. But the thing is, I think one of the white boys started dating one of their sisters and there was a lot of beef. And Steve Harvey was the judge and he was like, yo, I want a clean fight dance session, no dirty shit. And they did dirty shit anyways. And Lil' Kim was involved. And it was dope.
Yeah. Was that a good recap? Yes, that's what happened, right?
Derek, was that a recap?
I don't know. I haven't seen the movie.
You haven't seen this movie?
No, yeah. But I picked it when it came out. I was in middle school, and it's all everybody talked about, and everyone was at school saying you got served. And
I remember that you really got annoying. Served. I remember from the Taco Bell commercial. Remember the Taco Bell commercial where the guy said, the white guy's like, you've got served. The
guy served him a taco and said, you got served.
Do you remember that?
No.
Oh, maybe this is all a dream. I feel like Derek Blythe. I'm like, was this all a dream?
I don't think I'd watch this movie, though.
I would. Joe,
no, I hate these. Oh. I hate these like realities where, I don't know, just like how far could you go with a dance crew? Yeah, have you ever watched those reality shows where it's like they'll go on?
Don't watch dance shows.
They'll go on like America's Got Talent or something, and it's sort of like, just with dance crews, they're so. I don't know. They're fine. You're not going to become a multimillionaire, even if your dance crew goes this farthest movie, it possibly could.
Derek? This movie I apologize. You sound like Baby's dad right now. You're being a hater.
Well, I think you should go in the corner.
Oh, no one puts Baby in the corner, motherfucker.
There you go.
You're like... You're
what a setup.
You're killing, dude. You're killing these guys' dreams, dude.
Dance crews are really boring.
Oh,
no, it's
come
true.
On.
Think about it like this. This whole movie is predicated on this universe where it's like this completely, completely niche idea subculture is like the main
movie about the polka championship. And they have accordions and shit.
No, it's like Aquila and the Bee or that jump movie where it's like spelling bees are the biggest thing in the world or like jump rope competition.
So much on the line for this like. Give me Baby's Corner.
What are you all up in arms about? It's fine.
Yeah, Joey, say what you got to say.
The reason why I'm really offended right now is because you guys are saying this from your perspective that isn't connected to this world. I'm sure there's people out there, whether it's spelling bee, whether it's dance groups, whether it's, I don't know, this is their life, and it is make or break for them, and they have dreams, and I think their story is deserving to be told, and I'm all here for it, dude. Don't get me wrong, Joey.
You're getting me all wrong. I know this works.
They have tough lives. They're from the school of hard knocks, and this is what they have as a community, and that's fine.
So why are you coming at
them? I'm not going to watch it because I think as an art form it's really boring, but that's fine if that's what they have. Some people have golf, and I think that's boring too.
Yeah, every movie about
you guys are haters.
I'm not
haters.
You're a misunderstanding,
Joey. This is how it works. You make a movie like The Mighty Ducks. That's about hockey, right? I liked that movie as a kid, but it's like hockey isn't like the biggest, like most important thing in the world. It's literally like people who like a thing. they make a movie about that thing, and then the people who like that thing watch it. In this case, it's dance competitions.
Yeah.
Only difference is there's just like this point in like the 2000s where this is like a huge thing, and they made so many different versions of this movie. And it's just kind of funny because it's like, you know, dance competitions as like, you know, in reality aren't like that popular, but they got really popular in movies for like 3-5 years, and everyone loved these movies. It's like, where did this come
Maybe
from?
Maybe you're just traveling the wrong circles, my friend. I'm sure there's circles out there where this is life or death.
When was the last time you did a dance competition, Joey?
Are you kidding, dude? I fucking...
Jitterbug competition in 52.
Yeah.
I There's nothing wrong with making a movie place. About
I'm
it.
I'm giving this trailer right now, I'm giving it an 8.
I will give this dance movie trailer a 6 because it was an average trailer for a funny concept, but it gets an extra point for Steve Harvey.
Steve Harvey gets a yeah, I couldn't
for
agree
sure,
more.
Yeah.
Derek, give Steve Harvey some love.
Oh, 3.
Woo! Wait, was that 3 with or without the Steve Harvey love?
Oh, with. I don't love Steve Harvey. I think he's a bad person.
He's a terrible person.
Oh,
I'm not going to
Are
God.
You like seeing him and stuff? Because he's a really morally bad person.
No.
Steve
Harvey's
you
one of the best.
He's
like one of the best stand-up comedians ever, dude. Have you
okay.
seen his
Really?
Yeah. You haven't seen his comedy?
No, but I've heard him talk about how men and women should
he's
be interacting.
He's really sexist and very religious. And just
I've heard
not
him
a good
talk
guy.
About the gays.
No,
yeah.
You got to watch his.
He has
his, you
some
have to,
backward ideas from the Dark Ages.
You have to watch Steve Harvey's half-hour special from, like, the 90s on HBO. It's so good.
If you I think that I agree that that's probably funny. I think he's a funny guy. I like Family Feud.
Oh, he's great on Family Feud. Watch his HBO
like
half-hour. You won't regret it. And then message us at Trailer Trashing on Instagram how much you love that half-hour. So, Rotten Tomato, boys. And I'm going to give you one hint. It got exactly what you think it got.
So that means I get to go first, and I'm going to give it an 18.
Derek?
31.
Yeah, Charlie wins. Wow.
Oh, baby, I'm on a roll.
It was a 14. Derek, I wanted you to win, but Charlie fucking did it. He went with his gut. We unleashed a monster. Now that Charlie's going with his gut, I feel like he's
unstoppable.
I don't think you'll ever lose Rotten Tomato ever again. Like, you really are on a stride right now. Like,
you really gave me some, like, Mr. Miyagi type, like, encouragement last time.
Just don't have the plot of Karate Kid 2 happen where, like, you try to fight Mr. Miyagi, because that made me sad.
All of these movies we're watching today remind me of the Karate Kid, because it's like in Dirty Dancing, she was like, I need to learn the ways of dancing. And then he was like, I got you. I'm going to teach you how to dance. You're going to come in and you're going to dance all over my you're going to grind.
But in the Karate Kid,
he didn't have sex with
Mr. Miyagi, though.
Yeah, because he was too paralyzed with PTSD from, I think, World War II, right? That's the plot of Karate Kid 2 you're talking about, right?
I think so. hey, Derek, my man, we are going to your favorite part of the show, and I want you to take it away with the Common Sense Media Christian Moms.
Woo!
Yay!
2 out of 5. Not great.
And what
dubious plot. oh my gosh. Dubious plot and characters, good dancing. It gave me a pop-up. I couldn't read. I just started reading it, and then it cut
Derek, what do the kids say?
I'm trying to get back to that. I accidentally clicked write a review, and it got stuck on that.
We're really getting fucked up on this website.
Edit it out, Charlie. Just edit this part out.
The dancing is great, but there are a lot of talk of drugs.
That's what the kids have to say.
Yeah.
Is there?
There's one instance of BS and H apostrophe E. What? Oh, ho. Thanks. Word ho. Okay. 5-second kissing clips. That's fun.
That's pretty long.
There's also a small violent scene and many small instances of shoving. So steer clear of this one, guys.
Wait, a 16-year-old kid back in 2008 goes, this movie isn't that bad. Come on, people. Are you really that strict with your kids? There is some violence and involves some drugs, but it isn't really that bad. But then he gave it 3 stars, so I guess 3 stars isn't that bad.
Finally, some common sense for common sense.
And and Charlie, can you let us know what the parents have to say about this movie?
Parents need to know that this movie has some strong language. A brother tells his sister she is acting like a hoe because she is out on a date. Characters deliver packages for a man who is apparently a drug dealer, and there's always a strong sense of pull of thug life. A child is shot and killed off camera. The main characters are, in general, responsible, respectful, and devoted to their families. One female character is committed to education and plans to become a doctor.
I love love the adult views are better for some reason. They're just so much more. They're so much dumber than the kid reviews. the one titled "I laughed the whole time I watched it," and the review is "I love watching You Got Served because it makes me fall in love." And then they gave it 1 star.
Wait, maybe they thought one's the best. That parent thought one's the best. I think.
I like the one that's just it's 5 stars. It's the title is "Good," and in all caps the review is. Good, very good movie.
I bet it was like somebody who's like son acted in this movie was like, let me give it a good star on the Christian app so people will listen to it. Watch it.
Like when they dance. One star.
So this movie has a couple fun facts. This one is dear to my heart. Kevin Federline made his film debut in this movie, but he was only like an extra in like one scene.
Whoa, Popo Zao.
Yeah, bow, bow.
Popo Zao.
Wait,
I have no idea what you guys are talking about.
He used to say Popo Zao, which is like his catchphrase, but it's Brazilian slang for a big old booty.
Ooh-wee. But he was like Britney Spears' backup dancer, right? That was his thing?
Yeah, I guess. I only remember Popo Zao.
Well, then he had sex with her, and then they had a kid.
Really?
Yeah. Like he's
Popo Zao.
He's Britney Spears' baby mama.
I think it's
baby dada. Baby, yeah, daddy, baby. Baby, I don't know. So Derek was right. This movie was so popular for some reason. It was so popular that people wanted to dance like this movie. So the cast and crew made an instructional video to teach people how to dance like the way they do in this movie.
How to serve.
But the thing is, it was so hard. These dances are so hard that everybody gave up and like nobody really like learned from it.
If they're so that's challenging, what we were saying why before. Are they so boring then?
No, it's like
so many impressive things that I find so boring. It's really impressive what they're doing, but I want to blow my brains out.
It's funny to me because this is kind of like, this is just kind of how they make movies, but sometimes they just choose something. Like you take an idea and you dramatize the shit out of it. Like, you know, people in the heat of like a dance battle, I'm sure are feeling very intense and into it, but dance battles are just not that dramatic. And that's why I was saying all the stuff I was saying before. Dance battles are not as dramatic as this movie makes them out to be.
It could be. To Joey's point, these
it cannot.
These could, like a really specific competition thing. Like I watched a Bollywood that was about cricket and I know nothing about cricket, but they made it super interesting and had the stakes really high. Like, They can be good, but it's just like...
I don't have a problem with it because that is how you make a movie. You make something dramatic. Movies are dramatic. But the funny thing to me is, like, the more and more obscure you make some dramatic movie about this thing, it's like I went to jazz school for drums for a little bit, and I was like, I saw Whiplash, and I was like, ha. This is really overly dramatic. And it's like, that's part of the fun. If you're not a dancer and you watch this, you'll be like, wow, dancing is crazy. And I guess that's why people really liked it. And people really liked Whiplash, but no one ever
skill or art that you don't know anything about looks like magic.
Well, speaking about drama, this next movie is very dramatic. And it actually is a movie I went into thinking I was going to hate it. And then I came out loving it. And I think it's time we watch it. And this trailer is called Billy
Eilish.
Elliot. Elliot. Billy Elliot.
Got you.
All right. You guys want a 3-2-1 or what?
You got served.
I got served on the You Got Served. Should we just call this the You Got Served special?
Let's roll that beautiful bean footage.
Round one. What you doing, man? Stick one on his chin. Jesus Christ, Billy Elliot. You're a disgrace to them gloves, your father, and the traditions of this box and all.
And off. Why don't you join in?
Forward.
Plenty of boys do ballet, you know.
Puffs. I don't know what to do.
Follow the others.
I don't know why you bother. I'm good at it. Are you Shay?
I haven't seen hide there, you would believe it once.
Where have you been?
Boxing, where do you think?
Where the hell's your fit?
Go!
Yeah! Hey! No!
Bali.
I used to go to Bali.
See?
Aye, for girls. Not for lads, Billy. Not friggin' Bali.
I thought of auditioning for the Royal Ballet School.
Aren't you a bit old, miss?
Not me, you.
I could have been a professional dancer.
Will you shut up?
I've got this audition in Newcastle in a couple of weeks. I want to be a ballet dancer here, like. Don't be stupid.
I'm not having any brother of mine running around like a right squat.
And two. Can't do it.
You're not even trying.
I am, miss.
I don't want to do your stupid audition. What do you want me to do it for your own benefit?
The Royal Ballet
School.
If you're a ballet dancer, then let's be having you.
How much is it going to cost? Is that absolutely necessary?
Once again, so the trailer... Yeah.
Movie's way better than the trailer, but that was
the movie's
trailer.
Way better than the trailer. I'm going to give that a 6 because that movie's so good and that trailer didn't... give me the same feeling the movie gave me. So 6.
Yeah, I'll give this trailer a 6.5. No, I'll give it a 7. It was just because I've seen the movie though, but like the trailer is actually like fine. It's fine. I'll give it a 6.
Derek, I want to hear your thoughts since you didn't see the movie.
I give it an 8. Gets me excited.
Yeah, so I'm giving it a 7.
Watch it. Giving it a 7. You convinced me.
Yeah.
See, this movie is heartbreaking, heartwarming. This movie is powerful. This movie is about just like, you know, the dangers of masculinity, just the need to express yourself no matter who you are and still be accepted by your family through the toughness of, like, you know, social problems and just generally, like, you know, like there's strikes, there's problems with the government, there's problems with your work, everyone's poor. This poor kid just needs to be able to express himself, but his family won't accept him, but he needs to be accepted, and it's very beautiful. And
I
really
love, and what's so good is the relationship with the dad. It's like the best version of like a dad who's against the son, because most of those movies make the dad be like this evil guy who's like, fuck my son for doing this. But in this movie, you realize the dad's actually a really good person, and like it's not like he's not coming from
He's trying his best. He's not to support his family. He's stuck in the hole of like the way he was raised.
Like in High School Musical, like that dad just seemed like a jerk. You know what I mean? That dad just seemed like an asshole. In this movie, the dad's actually like, oh man, I feel bad that he doesn't understand his son.
Yeah, and it's like he tries, and they there's a lot of struggling. I've seen this movie. I saw it when I was a kid. I also saw it on Broadway.
I saw it on Broadway too.
Yeah, with the music from Elton John.
Yeah, Elton John. He saw this at like the Cannes Film Festival, and after he saw it, he literally called up his producers and was like, "Guys, we're gonna make another Broadway hit, baby."
Yeah, I mean, this is a really good movie. And the thing is, it's like this concept can get really cheesy, and I feel like...
And they don't make it cheesy.
Yeah, because... Yeah, and it was also... This movie's been around for a long time, and like... And this... It's like... You know, we're in 2020 and everyone's supposed to be very accepting and everything. So, like, movies like this have been watered down to the point where it's, like, you know, very, very cheesy concept. But this is ahead of its time. It was, like, it was poignant because this was made before people were accepting of other people. So it was, like, it was really showing people, like, what it means to be accepting and the struggle to be yourself. And, like, you know... That is powerful, and it is a powerful movie.
And to say one more thing on that, a lot of like these movies that have run the risk of being cheesy, they get cheesy because they try to be both funny and sad, but they don't execute either well. In this movie, the laughs are so fucking funny. The jokes in this movie are fucking amazing jokes, but then the sad parts are such good tearjerkers, and they have the perfect balance of sadness and funny. I'm going to stop great thing about this movie, because you get the point. It's a good movie. Derek,
watch this movie.
Ballet.
Be yourself.
That's
dance.
For girls. You're a lad. You're a lad. Not a lassie. That's for girls. Ballet.
I know knew your place. Second. I knew the second I decided to put Billy Elliot in this that Derek would have a field day of
set
accents.
Set me off like a parakeet. Ballet, that's for girls. Twirling around on the table. For who? For who?
For who? I can't do it.
For who? You're a lad. Look in the mirror, mate. You're a lad. You're a bloke.
You're just a bloke.
This trailer made me realize why we were questioning all of the other trailers and like what these dance movies are about and like why it's always a movie where it's like you're not allowed to dance and then you have to dance. And it's like this is the movie that actually does it. Like,
yeah,
like
finally justified reason not to dance.
Yeah, like Dirty Dancing is like I'm not supposed to dance because you're the help and my dad's rich and he's not going to like this. It's like it's the same concept, but Dirty Dancing is absolute bullshit. And the funny part is like the dance battle ones don't actually have that. Like I thought that we were going to see some sort of like thing like that, but that was
sure
just
they
like,
have their own tribulations.
Yeah, but yeah. You have to make a script. So, you know, something has to go wrong.
Trials as well as tribulations.
Yeah. But this one is real.
Trials and tribulations.
This was life or death, but not in a cheesy way.
Yeah. Gosh, what a movie.
What a fucking trailer. Looks trailer.
I didn't know what to do with this when I was a kid.
I felt so weird because I remember like telling my dad, because my dad like forced us to watch this, and I was like, no, this movie's stupid. I don't want to watch it. And then when the movie was over, my dad was like, so you liked it? And I was like, no, I didn't like it, but I loved it. I loved it. But like, I couldn't admit it to my dad that this movie was incredible because I don't know why. I was a fucking asshole.
We should
asshole.
Make a movie about that. In a world where Joe Rinaldi wants to love the movie Billy Elliot but feels pressured by his dad to hate it. How does he express himself?
No, my dad
that
wanted me to
love
no.
girls. No, it's not a scoot. It's about finding your voice in an oppressive society.
No, the funny thing is my dad actually loved it. He wanted me to love it. And I was like, no, I'm a man.
This movie is for girls.
That's a girl movie. Ballet. I like you got served. That's a girl movie.
So what do you think this got on the tomato meter? Charlie, you
very
go
very high. This got an 87.
Derek?
93.
Charlie Weinschenk, your gut is the best gut in the tomato history.
Yeah.
It was an 85. Woo!
Yeah. My gut is this is how I'm gonna do it from now on. You're right, Joey. I just had to trust my gut, but my oppressive family was like, Charlie, you cannot listen to your gut. I can't do it. I can't.
Wait, Derek, can you be Charlie?
Your gut to play Rotten Tomatoes. Rotten Tomatoes.
Derek, is this the first time you've ever been swept on the tomato game?
You've been
game?
Swept.
Yeah, I got thoroughly served.
You got served, dude. You got so served. I don't even know if I have any fun facts about this movie. It's so good.
Let's just, to quote Pink, Derek, you got scurvy. She made a really stupid song with a music video of her on a green screen and like a boat, and she was dressed as a pirate, and the whole song, all the lyrics were, we've got scurvy.
Wow.
You don't remember that?
No, I don't remember that.
It's a hit song.
I don't have any. I don't have any.
You should look it up. It's some real garbage.
Scurvy.
Don't know no songs about no citrus disease. Citrus disease.
Citrus is for girls.
It's a pirate disease, mate. Man walks into a bakery, and he says, right, is that a donut or meringue? And the baker says, yeah, it's a donny. You got it? Because he walks in, the baker thinks he says, is that a donut or am I wrong? But the baker hears, no, we hear meringue.
It sounds like you're from Glasgow right now. Like you do that Glasgow accent.
It's Glaswegian, yeah. Is that a donut or meringue? Yeah, you're right, it's a donny.
Boy,
yeah, I get it because you've explained it to me.
If you guys have fun facts about Billy Elliot, please message me because I couldn't find many fun facts, but I'm sure there is fun facts out there. The only one I have is that over 2,000 b- boys auditioned for the lead of Billy Elliot, which I don't know how that's physically possible.
It took a long time, probably.
Long time.
2,000 ballet boys.
In your Glaswegian accent, do you want to take away the Roger Ebert?
What, Patty?
He gave it a 3 out of 4. I feel like it's a 4.
I feel like he got robbed. This movie got robbed.
He gave whatever that fucking, I don't know. He gave, what did he give? The fucking Hangover got a perfect score?
Yeah.
Got a 3. Fucking A. Yeah, Derek, give
the
us
the last paragraph, he just talks about the F word.
Do it.
Wait,
there are two solutions to the linkage of the F word and the R18. One, the MPAA should concede the melancholy fact that every teenager has heard this and most other nasty words thousands of times. Or two, filmmakers should sacrifice the effort in order to make their films more available to those under 17.
Well, I love when he fucking does this.
I love when he does that, but I feel like we got to get something about Billy Elliot. So want to do the first paragraph, Charles?
Yeah, yeah, I'll do it. Billy Elliot is the flip side of Girl Fight.
Girl Fight! Girl
Fight! I don't
remember
this movie.
It sounds hot. Girl Fight! It does sound hot. Girl Fight. It sounds hot.
Sounds like
is
an
that
indie band.
It's a movie? It's a movie. It does sound like an indie band.
That should be the name of our band.
I
clicked it. He gave Girl Fight 3.5.
Whoa!
What?
He liked it better.
Yes. Yeah,
is it hot?
It's the flip.
I don't know.
I don't know. What is it? What is it? We have to do. We have to do a Girl Fight in an episode. So
it's a sports movie.
Really?
Oh yeah, this movie
it's
looks
boxing
frightening.
Movie with ladies.
Still hot. All right, read the paragraph.
Let me read this
Charlie.
Paragraph. While the recent American film is about a girl, oh, so all of our questions are answered if you just let me.
I hate us. Oh my fucking god.
Me too.
We're a toxic group of people.
Literally says everything.
Well, the recent American film is about a girl who wants to be a boxer and is opposed by her macho father, but the support of her mother. The new British film is about a boy who wants to be a ballet dancer, but is opposed by his macho father and brother. Both films feature supportive adults who encourage the dreams, but oppose rigid gender definitions. Both end in a big fight/dance. Girl Fight is tougher. Billy Elliot is sweeter. I suppose that's appropriate.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Fuck girls!
The funny part to me is that in the you can even see it in the trailers that Billy Elliot is starting out and he's supposed to be up. He's like he boxes and then he's like, no, I want to dance the ballet. I can't do it. God.
You sounded like the dad in that really bad show that Futurama made for Netflix with
The Disenchantment.
Yeah, you sound like the character John DiMaggio plays in that show.
I didn't hate it. I don't think it's good, but
I
watched all of it.
It's awful.
It's fine.
Okay. Is there a second season?
Yeah,
there's two seasons. Yeah. First season was better.
I didn't watch the second season.
It's not as bad as
so,
you think it is.
So, boys, do you have any last thoughts on dancing movies?
Was that a donut or a meringue?
I think, if you want my final thoughts for real.
Give us your final. Give it to us.
As with everything, there is a wide variety, some good, some bad, some awful, some amazing. Billy Elliot is good for the reasons that it is genuine and it has even some of the similar plot points of Dirty Dancing, but it really hits it home, hits it hard, and it's good. And I don't know. So some good, some bad. We watched two bad, one good.
So today we got the good, the bad, and the ugly of dancing movies. And that concludes the dance special edition of Trailer Trashing. Thank you guys so much for listening. We learned so much. We learned that Patrick Swayze and that gray girl hate each other. We learned that if you fuck up in dancing, you'll get fucking served. And Steve Harvey was in that movie. And we also learned that Billy Elliot has hilarious, hilarious accents that Derek loves doing. And thanks for listening. We'll be back next week again, Knuckleheads. If you liked what you heard, check us out on Instagram. Give us a 5-star review on the podcast app. And please do not forget to tune in to Derek. What's the name of it?
Tune into that thing.
Insert the name. It's usually Star Power, but we're doing a different name.
But how can they find it? How can they find it? Look up Soupy Garbage Juice.
The Instagram is lebeau.video.
Lebeau.video. And that's it for us. See you again next week, knuckleheads. I said that two times today, but it's okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.